with Ben Lorica, Chief Data Scientist, O'Reilly. Thanks so much for joining us.
Okay. Glad to be here.
So you did a survey. Yeah. Let's dig into that a little bit, but kind of give me the one surprising finding you found in there the most.
I mean, I think for me, one of our goals in the survey was to understand to what extent are people engaging with deep learning.
Sure.
Because deep learning is, I would say, one of the main drivers behind the resurgence and interest in AI. Mm-hmm. But we always associate it with the Silicon Valley stalwarts, the Googles, the Facebook, Microsoft, right, and companies like that. So we wanted to understand to what extent is deep learning in the minds of regular companies.
Sure.
So what we found is over 50% of companies have serious plans to use deep learning in the future.
That's awesome.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, and where do you think that, when you get a preponderance of companies then using that, where do you think AI can go then in the next couple of years?
I think the tools are getting easier for companies to use. There's more sharing of knowledge and best practices. And there's also more use cases that companies can relate to, because let's face it, not all companies are tackling self-driving cars or
right, and they see a tangible example that works, it makes them more apt to do
that. In their industry.
Yeah. Exactly, that's the very key point, right? Yeah, because if you don't have an example in your industry, that's not always easily applicable.
Right.
And so now as you get more crossover, so you can kind of see the life cycle of AI advancing just like any tech, you know, or any innovation in tech. As you've been here, and this is probably the laziest question I'll ask all day, but as you've been here, what is a trend or a thing that's been discussed the most that is, you know, creating chatter or maybe, you know, surprised you?
I think a few things. One is there's more interest among people in the data community on topics that are maybe we don't associate necessarily with the first things that the technical people will tackle, right? So things like privacy,
sure.
Fairness, and bias.
You've been hearing bias a lot.
Yeah, yeah, and things like that. So that's one trend. And then the second trend is, like I said, we started, our first AI conference was in New York in 2016. Mm-hmm. And at that point, what we really wanted to do was become the industry gathering place for people interested in building AI applications, because there are a lot of good academic conferences out there already. And so, but at that point in 2016, honestly, it was mostly aspirational for people. And you could see that from the people who attended our first event. They were mostly there to understand what is this about. Their job titles may have been much more on the management and innovation side. Now we have real engineers and developers, as well as business people, wanting to understand how do I bring this back into my company.
Yeah, I was going to ask, how have you seen that evolve over the three years? But that's kind of where you've seen it the most. You've seen a different kind of class of people come here. You've seen different people who want to interact with it inside the organization.
Yes. So, for example, we're in New York City, mm-hmm. which is associated a lot with financial services. So yesterday we had a whole day of sessions geared just for that vertical. So I think if I were to look at our conference in the early days, it would have been harder to string together so many talks of actual use cases in a certain industry. So to me, that tells me that people are already out there really getting their hands dirty and building things.
Which makes it interesting, like, what will this look like in 2020? What tangible advice can you give business leaders who are kind of trying to close the gap on the AI skills gap?
I think that one is understand the current state of technology as best as they can, right? So what are the limitations, what are the challenges? Take a look around at what other companies in your particular domain are doing.
Right. Shameless stealing.
Just to get inspiration in some ways, right?
Yeah.
And then start out with a smaller project, right? So don't identify something in your organization that might lend itself to this current generation of technologies, right? So one of the things that we tried to describe in our short keynote yesterday is that When people talk about machine learning and AI, that usually brings up the topic of automation. And to some people, to many of us, we think of automation frequently in terms of an either or, right? So either you're doing automation or you're not. But reality is automation occurs on a spectrum.
Very good point.
So a classic example being self-driving cars. That industry has five well-defined levels. Only at the highest level, the fifth level, do you achieve full automation. So you can think about the same thing in an enterprise workflow, right? So you don't have to say, I'm going to automate this whole thing. There might be bits and pieces of it that lend itself to being automated now with this, the current state of technology. And then the rest of it you can tackle later, or maybe that's good enough. Maybe all you really need is to augment and increase the productivity of your people who, after all, have the domain knowledge.
Yeah, you see, like, self-driving is a good example. You see that slow integration of, okay, you know, now a car will kind of have elements, right? It will do a little bit. It will navigate a little bit through a lane. You know, that's a slow introduction of what can eventually be seen, but you're almost kind of testing that, right? And then you have smart signals and kind of all of the data read that you have to do to make sure that a city can actually properly do that. So that seems like a slower industry than maybe like healthcare.
Right.
Healthcare, where do you see maybe the fastest adoption then?
I think the technology that really seems to be at the state where it can target a lot of applications is computer vision. Mm-hmm. So images and video are now the technologies at the point where you can unlock the value of a lot of that data. Which actually, you look back 3, 4, 5 years ago, they were beyond the reach of regular companies, right? So now, imagine huge troves of images and video that are available that used to be, you know, something you couldn't use in any of your analytics or business intelligence, because you can take those data types and just even do simple things, right? So how many times do simple counts, right? So before, all you had was metadata on that type of data sets. So video, all you had to go on was the title and description, and then you would rely on those being sufficient to describe what's embedded in the video. Now you don't have to do that. You can use computer vision to go in there frame by frame, right? So
No, it's exciting to see where this conference will look like in 2020, 2021, with just the adoption and the advance of technology. But thanks so much, Ben.
Yeah, thank you.
And to learn more, go to adobethinktank.com.